So I'm writing about a world where everything is a computer. It's cars, medical devices, drones, thermostats, power plants, weapon systems, smart city, anything. It's the fundamental difference between your computer crashes and you lose your spreadsheet data and your embedded heart defibrillator crashes and you lose your life. And as much as privacy matters and our medical data matters and even our bank accounts matter, it's just bits. When it becomes life and property, things change. So two things that I think are failing in interesting ways. The first is that patching is failing. And so our computers and phones are as secure as they are for two basic reasons. One, there are teams of engineers at Apple and Microsoft and Google that do their best to build them securely. And two, those same teams are there working round the clock to write and push out patches when vulnerabilities are discovered in the wild. So this doesn't hold for low-cost embedded systems like DVRs and home routers. They're built at a much lower profit margin, they're often built offshore by third parties, and they don't have dedicated security teams. Teams come together, build them, then disband. The way you update your home router today is you throw it away and buy a new one. That's the patch mechanism. And actually, that is something that gets us more security. Right, we get security from the fact that we replace these things every, 2 to 3 years. Embedded systems don't work that way. Right, you replace your DVR every 10 years, your refrigerator every 25 years. You go home, find yourself a 42-year-old computer and boot it up. Right, try to make it work, try to make it secure. We as an industry have no idea how to maintain 40-year-old software. Mass market. We could do it niche, but we can't do it for everybody. I'm not convinced this is gonna scale. Second thing I think is gonna fail is authentication. The amount of authenticating is about to explode. And it's not just normal ones. It's people authenticating to things authenticating to people, and even worse, things authenticating to things. Right? So when this talks to my car, it's because I was around when they met each other. Right? It works through Bluetooth, and I was there to pair them. That works okay if I've got 10 things. If I have 100 things or 1,000 things, and they want to talk to each other, right? That's 100,000 authentications. I'm not going to be there for it. So we need some way to do thing-thing authentication at scale. Some of it's going to be through hubs. And right now, if you have any IoT anything, you almost certainly control it through your phone. Right? The phone is now the de facto IoT controller. And maybe you can offload some of this on everyone authenticates to the phone and the phone does the pass through. I'm not convinced that's gonna work. It's not gonna work for smart cities or smart organizations. It might work in the home. This is really what I'm writing about in my book. Autonomy, automation, physical agency bring new dangers.